他にご注文はございますか？他にご注文はございますか？ありがとうございます。
ちょっとね。
お呼びとある、新しい。さあ、以上でよろしいですか？またのご用命。 他にご注文はございます。ありがとうございます。
千里を見通す強大なドラゴン、誰もが恐れる比類なき見識の王ハインデルよ。願わくば姿を現せ、私の問いに答えてくれ。
お前の願いは叶わぬ、ハインデルを求めろ。たとえ世界の果てまで探したとて無駄なことだ。
ドラゴンよ、お前がハインデルではないのか。
我が友人は賢くも愚かだった。忠告を聞かず人間に関わった挙句無残な返礼を受けた。幾千の剣でもってしても流輪は砕けぬ。だがドワーフどもが作り上げたそのおぞましい魔石の刃は別だ。ハインデルの胸を突き破り、神にも等しい我らに死という屈辱を与えた。
この剣は冥界で渡されたものだ。ハインデルの死など私は知らない。ここへは呪われたこの身の行くべき道を乞うために来たのだ。
黙れ竜の仇、どこまで我らに害をなす。ベリアルの魂を奪い我らの卵を盗み、アリクにハインデルを殺した。今その呪わしい剣にまみえて一通りで血は逆流し日も触れんばかり。
待ってくれ、私には何一つ覚えがない。
言い訳は聞かぬ、命乞いも無用だ。今お前を誇る者の名を教えよう。竜巻の王にして早急の覇者、我こそは全てを滅ぼす者ワーグナー。祈りの糸間なく地獄の豪華で焼き尽くしてくれようぞ。
ワーグラン、私をどこに連れて行こうというのか。
この真の層に刃を打ち込む得難い好機にお前はためらった。情けで命を長らえるのは屈辱だが、お前の心根には感じ入るものがある。竜を傷つけるその武器と、それらを生み出す輩は許すことはできん。だが一度だけお前の慈悲に応えよう。お前の問いに返答を与えよう。
この呪いのことを教えてくれるのか。
一夜にして滅んだ魔法王国の話を聞いたことがある。今は亡き王国バレンタインに伝わる呪詛がその姿の原因だ。
姫の国の名だ。イングベイという男の言うことが本当なら辻褄は。
国は失ったが民は死んだわけではない。皆呪いを受けプーカとなり果てたのだ。プーカたちは呪いを解くために結束して働いていると聞く。
元の姿に戻る方法があるのか。一体どうすれば。
そこまでは預かり知らぬ。眼下を見るがいい。荒野はかつてのバレンタイン国首都だった。だが今は妖精どもの領土、魔王と取り合いを続ける争い絶えぬ地だ。この下にプーカの住む場所がある。あとは当人らに尋ねてみるがいい。これで貸し借りはなしだ。名もなきプーカよ。
私の名はコルネリウス。感謝するワーグナ
ー。勘違いをするな。我が復讐は続く。その狂人を振るう者はいずれも許さぬ。次にまみえる時はなめてはかからぬぞ。お前も油断せぬことだ。
さて困ったぞ。どこからその町へ入ったらいいのか。おや、あれは。君、待ってくれ。
あら、見ない顔ね。ダメよ、こんなところをうろついてちゃ。
私はタイタニアのコルネリウス。プーカの町を探しているのだが。
まあ珍しい。よその国のプーカだなんて。私はメリル。異国の方でよくここが分かったわね。
この呪いを解く方法をあなた方は知っていると聞いたのだ。
どこでそれを。私たちの秘密なのに。でもあなたもプーカだし、協力するなら教えてもいいのかしら。
人の道に戻らぬ限り何だってしよう。
誰にも喋ってはダメ。秘密を守れる。
天とこの命に固く誓う。
いいわ、教えてあげる。どんな魔法もプーカを人間に戻せない。ただ一つの魔法を除いては。それがバレンタインで作られた魔法のコイン。世界にある全てのコインを集めれば、どんな願いも一つだけ叶えられるの。願いはもちろん皆の呪いを解くこと。
作られたコインを全て集める。一体どのくらいの数なんだ。
皆で集めているのだけれど、まだどれだけあるのか。一つの国全部の効果を集めるのは並大抵じゃないのよ。あ、いけない。こんなところで立ち話をしていると大変。もうすぐこの辺りも戦場になるわ。妖精たちに挑む魔王の軍隊がやってくる。来て、私たちの秘密の町はこっちにあるの。
どうすればいいんじゃ。わしはもう我慢がならん。ベルベット様が一人。
ベルベット。
いやあ、地下のこの町はどうだい。今は他の国が地上を占領しちゃってるから、この町。
新入り君、コインアこの国で作られた魔法、これがバレンタインの金貨、こっちが王女様の銀貨、ベルベット様とイングベイ様の母君よ。そして最後はコインに魔法がかけられた時に作られた記念硬貨よ。
いらっしゃいませ。ご注文はどうなさ。かしこまりました。以上でよろしいでしょうか。以上で。ありがとうございました。いらっしゃい。ご注文はどう。かしこまりました。ありがとうございます。何か必要なもの。
待って、やっぱり危ないわ。
君こそ戻るんだ。私は行かねばならない。
あなたに結晶炉のことなど話すのではなかった。
魔法技術の粋を集めて作られた結晶炉、魔王軍と妖精軍の争いの火種、ね、その炉の火を止めるために姫が一人でこんな戦の最中に出られるなんて、胸騒ぎがする。ベルベット姫、
あなたはどうしてそんなにベルベット様を気にかけてくださるの？
今は話せない。それより今まさにこの辺りで結晶炉を奪い合い、魔王軍と妖精軍は戦っている。姫はどうして危険なこの時になって行かれるのか。
亡くなったはずのバレンタイン王が現世に戻られたからです。今の結晶炉は動いていても眠っているようなもの。でもあの方はあの最悪の時のように炉を操ることができる。
君が話してくれた領土を吹き飛ばし国民をプーカに変えた最悪のことだな。自国の崩壊を願うとは、なんという王だ。
結晶炉でバレンタインは滅びました。その悪夢がもう一度現実となるかもしれない。王をお止めできるのはおそばにおられたベルベット様だけなのです。
この通り私の剣は特別だ。心配は無用、必ず姫の助けとなります。ベルベット、会えたとしてもこの姿では私だとは分かるまい。だがあなたを守る、たとえ名乗れずとも。
Oh, Thank you. 前のプーカ殿、今ここは戦場です。急いで離れて。ブリガン将軍の部隊も来ているのです。我が軍からも。
以上でよろしいですか？はい、お任せあれ。お召し上がりください。他にご注文はございますか？以上でよろしいですか？またのご。 ありがとうございます。
Hey, dude. I hope you can hear me.
I'm good, mate. I hope you're doing all right as well. I'm just playing some of my Japanese games. I love this game. Did you ever play this before? It used to be on the PS2. This remaster of it is absolutely fantastic. They've made about a million times better game out of it. It's unbelievable. Yeah, I mean, I couldn't wait. I just had to get the Japanese version. I'll get the English version as well, or the Western version when it comes out as well. That'll be about the fourth time I bought the game. But this is so much better. It's unbelievable how much better it is than the original one. And that was good. Okay. Ooh, where are we going next? This way. Got the key now. Yeah, I was gonna hold back, but it was my birthday last month, and my girlfriend said, well, "What do you want? Do you want me to get some US credit? You know, US piercing credit?" I went, "You know, you could get me some Japanese piercing credit instead, my love." And so she did. So yeah, so I bought this instead. Right, and it got the key. It's feeling, I've got my big boots on. It's shiny there, look. It's going. So what you can do in this one, what you couldn't do in the old game, is like you can release the photons as well, or just let them out and suck them back in again. So you got much more space in your inventory as well, and it's just better organised. It's just much easier to do stuff. Lots of food. Let's do one of these. I'll eat this. I'll plant that, and I'll just let them out. There we go. And then we can eat it, and we can see what you can do is now you put them in there, and then you can kind of just eat it all in one go instead of waiting, doing it one at a time. Space have I got? Not a lot. Get rid of that. Okay. Look at that. Juggle, 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 juggle. Good, this is so much fun to play now. Oh, it's going in, it's beautiful. Rank. Ooh, luck up. Yeah, this is, I'm not having too much trouble playing this because obviously I played it in English before, but I've got my smartphone and my Google Translate, so you just take a picture of the screen and it tells you what the Japanese words mean. It's great. Oh, look. There's a shiny. And there's a little creature there. Look, boom, there you come. It's got a bone. There's another one. Make a potion. I mean, I remember when the PS2 version came out, and I had to have it. When I just saw it, and I'm not a big anime fan. I mean, but this game is absolutely beautiful. It's the, you know, the music and the graphics and the animation. You know what I mean? It's incredible. It's like a work of art. All these VanillaWare games are fantastic, and it's incredible that they actually went back and revisited this game again and just kept all the everything that was wonderful about it, and just ripped out the battle system basically and everything, and just put a whole new one in, and it's just so much better. I mean, and I enjoyed it before. Some people found it a bit annoying and a bit repetitive, fair enough, but I can't see anyone wouldn't like this game anymore, because it's just so much fun to play, just juggling combos, so many moves, so much leveling. It's brilliant. It's brilliant now. It's absolutely brilliant. So I've already I've obviously, if you played it before, you've got five characters. You've got Gwendolyn, you've got Cornelius, this guy, and then you've got Mercedes, and then Oswald, and then Velvet. So, and you play them through in order. So I've already completed Gwendolyn's story, so I'm on to the second one now. I'm getting towards the end with this guy, and I was going to keep going. It's a bit of a shame I'll miss out most of the story. But I've already played it in English, so it shouldn't be too bad. Right. I'm just going to look up. Oh, look, so we've got all this stuff now that was never in the original one. You've got all of these skills to learn and to power up. Yeah, Dragon's Crown's awesome. I wouldn't be surprised if we get a Dragon's Crown 2. I mean, it's... Dragon's Crown, I think, was their most successful game for VanillaWare. I think they sold plenty of copies of it. I think the fact that it was their most successful game means that there's a fairly high chance, I think, that you will get a sequel to it. I would not be surprised to get Dragon's Crown 2 in the next year or so. Because, I mean, they're not the biggest team. They've obviously been working on this game, but I think, you know, I think that they probably had enough. There's something else that they've been working on as well as this game. And I would not say, I wouldn't be surprised if it's Dragon's Crown 2. I wouldn't, even if it's not, whatever these guys do is going to be good. Whatever they do. If it's a brand new type of game, I bet it'll be just as good as Dragon's Crown anyway. So we've got all these other skills that we can learn here now. You get your ability points. Every time you level up, you get a level, you get ability points. So I've unlocked all this stuff. So that's pretty good. That gives you 20% extra XP and food. That's cheaper, 20% cheaper shop prices. I think that's 30% extra hit points, XP, I think, from items that you use, and you've got all these other ones, wrists. And as you say, you can use the Phozons to level up this. This is your main weapon, so that's 7 out of 9. I'll power that up, so I do a lot more damage. Very handy. Obviously, you've got equipment, multiple stuff here, and it's all, it adds to your defense. There. Obviously, it's the classic story. If you ever played Ionosphere, then you know, look, you can see the timeline of the story. So, here's Cornelius's storyline, there's Gwendolyn's that I've done. Obviously, you do all five across there, and then you get to do the bit at the end, all this bit here. Look at that. Can't wait to get there. Let's save the game whilst I'm here. Look, still got the... you know what's great about this game? It's got the original game in it as well. Even though this is the whole new version of the game, on the title screen you can choose original, and you can just play the original version of the game with better graphics. It's 22.5 hours already. Okay, right. Where are we going? Where's the boss? There's those shiny apples, which I don't know what the hell they do, but I keep collecting them. That key must be for the boss. There's a bag down there. I'm gonna go down, I think, first, and go up, and then go to the boss. Set for my special power. Come on again. Here we go. So here's this magic, the skills that I've got. As you can see on the right hand side of the screen, you can set four of them to shortcuts, which is directions and the circle button. So that's, you can see when I'm doing those extra special moves, I'm using the shortcuts. But you can also just pause in and come in and do some of these bigger stuff, which does a few crazy things. Oh, he hit me. And backstabbing like that. And back to this guy as well. Trying to defend. And another thing there, like the top right button. So what we've got here, we've got some more seeds, and we've got a lobster there, which is great for dinner. You see this is the R1 button, and it's basically like cancel, you know, dodge, almost Bayonetta style, where you can just pull yourself out of a combo or just out of an attack. It's just like your quick recovery, just back into the game again. Oh, so good. Right, where are we going? Let's go down. Just check the level out for stuff. There you go. Oh, something there. It must be full. Yep. Let's eat something. An apple. Ooh. That was fun. Look at that. Each time we get over 1,000, means you're awesome. What have we got? Oh, a recipe that looks yummy. See. Rest area, so I should have the opportunity to make some dinner and to visit the shop. Well, you like the fact that I play lots of different types of games. I love video games. Exactly, my friend. Exactly. You can't just limit yourself to one type of game. You're not a true video game lover. You know what I mean? There's beauty to be found in video games across all the spectrums of all the genres. From role-playing games to shooting games, beat-em-ups, puzzle games, whatever. I mean, you know what? You know what am I playing at the moment? I'm playing The Witness, this, Star Wars Battlefront, Assassin's Creed Syndicate. I'm having a good time with that. What else am I playing? Oh, what have I got? So much stuff. Dishonored I got the other day. I've got Exist Archive, Tearaway. I play farming simulator games. I mean, Verbal Galaxy, space game. We played that, that's fantastic. We played Euro Truck Simulator on the PC. Farming simulator, you know, anything. I've been playing on my Wii U, I've been playing Rodeo Sky Soldier and Splatoon and Xenoblade and Mario. Games. I love them. All of them. Right, let's dump some of this stuff. Look, we've got a big inventory now that we can use. What do you think we don't need here? Oh, yeah. Put that one away. Oh, gingerbread man. Scrambled egg. Yeah. I watched a video of that about a month or so ago. I mean, it looks interesting. I'm not quite sure what it is. I mean, I watched it. Was the guy went to like the fire? He's got a job for watching the in the fire tower, and he goes away to do something. He comes back. It's been smashed up. And that was what I saw in the video, but I think there's a lot more to it than that. But interesting, and Unravel. I've got an Xbox One, and I've got EA Access on it, so I know they've actually Unravel is actually one of those sort of free 10-hour demo type games on the EA Access, but I haven't got around to downloading it yet, so I'm going to try it on there first before I buy it. But if I buy stuff, I tend to buy it on the PS4. Let's have a look. Let's dump one of them. The stuff I've collected. I don't know what it does. Right. What's he selling? Milk? Go and get something to eat first. Let's make use of this plant. I'll have to give it a bit extra because that won't be enough. couple of hundred things here. Yeah, I mean, Sony pretty much, you know, poo-pooed the idea of having EA Access on the PS4, because I guess they realised it was going to be a pretty decent competition for PlayStation Plus, I think. Which is a shame, really, because that EA Access is actually pretty damn, you know, some people don't like EA, but goddamn, they do make some good games. And they're making Mirror's Edge. I mean, like, some people love to hate on EA, but you know, there's quite a few good games that they make, and some people really like them. I mean, you know, I like football, you know, but I don't really that interested in playing football games that much, not on my own anyway. Imagine a world without FIFA, all those football people, that, you know what I mean? They make great sports games for people who like those sort of things. And you know, they're making a sequel to Mirror's Edge. And I love Mirror's Edge. I cannot wait for Mirror's Edge Catalyst to come out. Oh my god, I'm so looking forward to that game. I hope it's as good as I wish it to be. But yeah, EA Access, you know, on the Xbox One, I mean, it's like, I don't want to ever want to buy FIFA, not that there's anything wrong with it, but I can go and play FIFA, I can play the whole game of FIFA on my Xbox One, because EA Access gives it to me. And there's Battlefield on there, Dragon Age Inquisition, even I've got it on PS4, Need for Speed, you know, I got Need for Speed on the PS4, and I got Battlefront on the PS4, and I got them because I played them on the Xbox One through EA Access 10-hour demo, and it made me like the game, so I wanted to buy them. That's why EA do it, because it's just easy advertising for their game that I pay for. Which is even... I think it's going to be interesting. Really, the true genius of Mirror's Edge is in its first person platforming gameplay, and I hope they don't forget that bit, and I'm sure that they won't, to be quite honest with you. I think Mirror's Edge is definitely a sort of, for DICE, the developer, the people who make it, I think it's definitely one of those games that DICE have always loved. They made it, it was a sort of something close to their hearts, and I think that DICE want to make a great Mirror's Edge game as much as everyone who likes Mirror's Edge wants a great Mirror's Edge game, so I'm pretty confident they're going to do alright. Yeah, I mean, as you say, you know, it's each to their own, isn't it, with things like FIFA. I like watching football, you know what I mean? I'm not the world's biggest football fan, but you know, I do enjoy watching a game of soccer, and I've been to plenty of football matches in my life, and there's nothing quite like being in the football crowd and cheering and shouting and getting excited. That's a great experience. But you know, FIFA, I enjoy a game of a football game on the computer against other people, mostly local co-op, not online. I got friends that don't like video games as much as what I do, but they want to play, they like football, they like sports, they want to play the football game, and it's great playing multiplayer football games with them. And it is I find playing something like FIFA exciting, but just like two or three games, that's all that I need. I only need to play a couple of games, oh, that was fun, but I don't want to sit there and play hours and hours and hours of FIFA, because I get very bored. And you know, but a couple of games is great for me. Right, let's actually do something useful here. What the hell was I was going to get some food. Oh, here we go. Come on. It's dinner time. Ooh, there's a shiny up. Now, I don't know if you can remember in the old PS2 game, you could only get dinners at a certain place, and now, like, you can just call this rabbit at rest zones and just make dinner whenever you like, which is great. Hey! Right, so here we go. Here's the brush uppies that I know. Now, the red ones are the ones that I don't have the ingredients for, unfortunately. The black ones I do, and the bonus ones, what they are is that the first three times that you eat the meal, you get extra experience points out of them. And that's what the bonus means. So I want to try and get the stuff. And look at this one, that looks pretty good. I want to do that one. Look at that, 20,000 XP plus 14,000 XP. But I know you can't get that little thistly green thing till right near the end of the sort of character playthrough. But I can do this one, and that's got quite a lot on it, so let's do that. Yeah, my little boy, he's 3 years old. He likes watching this game because he likes looking at the bunny. He loves the bunny. So let's do that, and then we'll have a bit of lobster. Should we go off and cook it? Hi. There you go, yum yum yum. Look at that, he's sitting there cutting up with his knife. Look at those graphics, it's wonderful. Ooh, didn't quite level up. I think she said we'd like some more. Yeah, why not? I want to save that lobster when I get that. Go to the shop and buy something. Get another level. Get some milk, some cheese. So you can pick out of your item box or out of your bag as well. You don't have to carry it all about with you. Hold down the button. It goes a bit quicker. There you go. Look at that. Very polite. What? Okay then, dude. I need to get a drink as well. Hopefully I'll catch you in a bit.
Nope, no secret area. Healing. Okay, dude. No problemo. Yeah, I thought I've gone on that before.
But obviously, as you get further in the game, they get more attacks and do more nasty stuff. I mean, he was drinking potions, that guy. And he does that charge, which is pretty nasty. But I've over-leveled myself, so it makes it nice and easy. Oh, I've got 300 things. I think there's three difficulty levels on this game. I'm just playing on the medium one, normal. Shining through that whoosh, look at that. It's just awesome. So I think I've got the key. Go up to the top of it first. Oh, what's that? Hello. Obviously, all these platforming sections never existed in the original version of the game. Alright, okay, so this is where you put these things on. Boots, it's just like playing Zelda. Help. There's actually secret areas in this game. You have to keep a lookout. There's there could be areas coming off of here where there's secrets. Oops, wrong button again. Come on. Nope, nothing there. Itself. I don't need it. Save. Oh, okay. Mid boss. Well, let's be a trial stage. Think about it. Yep. It's two of them. Oh, I hate that one. Ouch. This one hit me. Yum. Oh.
need some of the cats for that. Nearly dead. Come on. I see you down. Damage took too long. Still not got an A. Let's look at what those bloody things are. I don't want to get backstabbed, that's 20% extra damage from behind. Okay, let's go level up. The art description. Tell me, Japanese translating thing. What's it say? The bomb there. Okay, it says fruit maximum 50 hit points, rise of vision that only those who survived the ordeal can be obtained. To 2000 recover hit points. Understanding what the words mean in Japanese is only half the story. Now we have to translate that bit. A vision of those who survived the ordeal. God, I don't know. I'll have to Google it. Let's see if Google helps. It's not helping either.
It's called Fruit of Miracle. That's what that says. It's a letter. It says C at the end. It's Fruit of Miracle. I've got a silver one on Gwendolyn. Oh. I don't know. The keep if I'm in. Spit's going to be windy. See if I can just have something to eat. Get one more level.
It is kaputt.
More dinner.
Dinner.
ありがとう。Well, let's attack a little bit. Okay, boss fight time.
さあ、その指輪を返してちょうだい。私がお母様から預かる指輪、誰にも渡すわけにはいかないわ。
この指輪は結晶炉コルドロンを操る鍵。コルドロンをすぐに止めねば。あの人がここまで来ている。
何を言っているの？
コルドロンの元々の支配者、指輪の主バレンタインも、あの人が王に牢を操らせてはならない。あの惨劇が繰り返される。
なんとか言って指輪を返さない気ね。出さないならこうよ。
ベルベット姫。
ベルベット
部下、お願いです、指輪を。
指輪
守って、誰にも渡してはなりません。
素直に渡した方がいいのに。私の石弓は魔法の弓、お前ごとくひとひねるよ。
姫によくも。だが見れば幼い子供のすること、見逃してやるから行くがいい。
バカにするな。お前だって小さいじゃない。もう許さないわ。
ちょっと待って、サイディス。
in the bronze girl. Here we go. Stand here and get that. Food everywhere. Goodbye. It's all gone.
で先導を名乗り出た資料
礼を言わねばならんな。おかげで顔色の悪いあの女に見つからずにこの世に戻れた。
その冠、うん、そうかお前が。
世が今や哀れなバレンタインの王、うなるコルドロンは我が心臓、そしてティトレンの指輪が我が玉座。これで指輪はあるべき主のもとへと戻った。
おじい様、考え直してください。
呪いの難を逃れたお前たち兄弟には分かるまい、この苦しみが。王大も妖精どももタイタニアも同じ地獄を歩むがいい。
世界の終焉をお望みなのですか？
この身をどう見る、虚無以外に必要とするものはあるかね。そうだ、終焉だ。預言書の言葉通り、地獄の釜の蓋が開くとき、それがまさに今だ。
その干からびた頭にはまともな考えは残っていないようだな。
プーカメ、タイタニアの伝説の剣を手にして勇者にでもなったつもりか。口の利き方に気をつけよ。ひざまずけ、世はそなたらの王ぞ。
お前を王にいただいた覚えはない。
バカ者め、邪魔をしよって。まだ終わらぬぞ、まだ。
姫、
ありがとう、ありがとう。ブーカ、
ベルベット姫、お会いしたかった。私です、コルネリウスです。いや、ダメだ。こんな姿になった私をもう愛せるはずがない。告げてはいけない。口を固く閉ざせ。今は耐えるのだ。バカ、 いつまで。
ここにいた。目が覚めたと思ったらすぐに飛び出すんだから。気分はどう？まだ寝ていた方がいいと思うけど。
姫は無事か？
ベルベット様がここに連れてきてくれたのよ。
彼女はどこに？
今ここにはおられません。なんだか慌てて出て行かれたわ。
Stone Striker. Sounds good. Passive. Yes.
国へ行く。私最近まであのお城でグウェンドリンというお姫様。
あの人だ。よかった。
いやー元気になった。バレンタ昔魔法のコイン
カズも
勇気必要。あなたは人
いらっしゃいませ。ご注文はどう？
Yummy.
以上だよ。以上でよろしいでしょうか？
ありがとう。
sheep. Good chocolate. Can I go back there?
メリル、逃げるんだ。ゴブリンが退去して攻めてきた。いや、こっちに来たぞ。
チッ、逃げやがった。臆病の毛むくじゃらめ。おい、この辺にもきっとあるぜ。がっぽりコインをいただいていこう。
あった、動くなよ、ウサ耳。その耳削ぎ落としてやろうか。
皮を剥いで襟巻きをこしらえるのかい。よさ、
ここはプーカの土地だ。出て行けゴブリン。
何を言ってやがる。俺らの土地だ。同じバレンタインの人間として権利はあるぜ。
いい加減なことを。
本当よ、心が横島なプーカがだんだんとゴブリンになっていったの。でもわからないわ、どうしてこんなことを。コインは感謝の言葉とともに送られなければ魔法は現れない。奪ったコインでは願いは叶わないのに。
そんなことは知ってるさ。俺らの王がお作りになったお金だからな。これはそのバレンタイン王のご命令よ。
バレンタイン王だと。
俺たちはこんなものに用はねえ。だがお前らだけ元の姿に戻るのを許す気もねえ。王様の言うように炎の国の溶岩へコインを投げ捨てりゃあんたらの泣きっ面を拝めるって寸法よ。
待て、大丈夫ですかメリルさん。
ダメよ、コインを失ったら。
What sort of spam do you get on Twitch these days? Yep. You're going to have a great time, my friend. I mean, I would advise trying to wait for the, like, you know, try and wait for the, you know, the Western version of it, because I don't know how much you played, but you know, I'm definitely missing out by playing the Japanese version. But there you go. Yeah, you're right. I've got too many games, and there's way too many good games coming out in the next few months. I mean, you got games next week. Street Fighter V. I'm terrible at beat 'em ups, but as we discussed earlier, I love video games and I do love Street Fighter, even though I'm rubbish at it. I really am, but I love it. So I could be tempted to get that game. And then we've got The Division. I've got that pre-ordered already. I really enjoyed the beta of that last weekend, so I've got that pre-ordered. I'm actually not that big an Uncharted fan, so I'm able to resist Uncharted 4. I'll probably get it a bit further down the line when it's a bit cheaper. Unless it's so good. What else is coming out? There's lots coming out. You can get the Japanese version of Final Fantasy 15. That's brave. You know, I wouldn't be surprised, you know, if the Western and the Japanese release date of Final Fantasy 15 are quite close together. They may not be the same day, but I wouldn't be surprised if they're actually quite close together. Normally they're not, I know, but I think I got this feeling they've been working on this game for so long. 10 bloody years they've been working on this game. You know, I think from playing the episode demo that they gave away with Type Zero, Final Fantasy Type Zero, I've got this funny feeling they're sort of working on the English version as along with the Japanese one. I do think it will come out fairly close. It may even be the same day. Yep, March the 31st, they're going to announce the release date, aren't they? Yeah, I can't remember, there's some event going on, isn't there? We'll get it before the end of the year, I think. I do have it actually pre-ordered at my favourite video game online retailer. I think it's going to be pretty good. I think it's going to look fantastic. I think it's going to be interesting. A lot of people didn't like Final Fantasy 13. I did. I really liked it. I played it on my Xbox 360. I didn't have a PS3 at the time when it came out. And I got all the 1,000 achiever, you know, gamer points in it. I completed it 100%. I got it all because I enjoyed it so much. So although I'm sort of looking at Final Fantasy 15 and not sure whether quite tell how good it's going to be, I reckon I'm going to like it anyway. I just hope we get Dragon Quest over here, Dragon Quest 11. I hope they bring that one over. We're certainly getting those two Dragon Quest games on 3DS. I don't know if you got one of those. More games to play this year. Okay. Let's see where we are. Okay, we'll start the level again. Level 30. Okay. Oops, wait. Watch out for these guys, I can poison you. There you go. Let's wait for that one. Yep. Yeah. Okay. Yeah, I played some Destiny. I think I played Destiny just before the last time I played Destiny was just before the Taken King came out. I think it was just the point where it got patched. So I haven't actually got the Taken King at the moment. There was a couple of times I thought about picking it up. I think it was at Christmas time. There was a fairly cheap, you could get it fairly cheaply, but I kind of thought, I just, don't get me wrong, I like Destiny. Destiny's a great game, but I just felt that I played my fill of it and had plenty of other games to play, so I didn't get Taken King. So I've kind of stepped back and I think to myself, I'll wait until they released, you know, Destiny 2 or whatever it ends up being, even though it sounds like it's been delayed. I mean, we all thought we were going to get something in September again, it sounds like that's been delayed. So I think I'll wait until the proper version of Destiny comes out and buy that, and hopefully that'll have all of the Taken King and all the previous stuff in it. I'm kind of thinking that I'm getting The Division next month, so I think The Division, although it's not exactly like Destiny, it's gonna satisfy that Destiny urge where you've got a shooting game with RPG mechanics. Oh yeah, I put many hours into Destiny, but I've managed to not play it too much. Okay, well, hopefully we'll get to. I'm definitely in. I've got The Division pre-ordered, so I'll definitely be in for that. Yeah, that's a great game. The Division, I thought it was really good. I mean, it's the shooting style is very different to Destiny. Destiny's got that Bungie Halo feel to it. You know what I mean? It's just got that great shooting feel that Bungie can do. The Division. It's much more sort of bullet spongy, much more Ubisoft stroke Rainbow Six feel to it. It's got that cover mechanics, that sort of slow but still satisfying shooting gameplay. I think some people find it a bit weird that you have to like put 200 bullets into someone to make them die, and it is a little bit weird, but at the same time I don't mind it because it's only a game and I like games. Yeah, I thought all the modifications, all the equipment and the leveling and the skills you could get in Division seemed pretty good. And obviously there's a lot of crafting in that, but that was none of that was available in the beta. So. I like numbers. I like numbers popping over the heads of things. Ever since Bubble Bobble. I just like seeing numbers pop above the heads of things, even though that's totally unrealistic. Numbers. Numbers going up is always good. Right, so look. What am I doing? Look at that lava. Okay, how did it feel? Oh, look at that steam, it's cool. Oh, that hurt me. Come down from there. I'm not going up, mate. Bastard. Yeah, okay, I see what you mean. Yeah, makes sense. Yeah, that makes a lot of sense, actually. Yeah, that's definitely so. That sounds pretty cool. Yeah, exactly. Yeah, Borderlands. You can certainly feel a little bit of Borderlands in Division, I think. In certain sense. Obviously, Division's taking itself quite seriously. I think a little bit. I mean, like the story missions that you, the story that you saw in the beta. Did feel a bit overwrought, I would say. You know, you had that kind of character that was in the helicopter, and then like she hurt her leg, and she was like, "Oh, I wish I could come out with you," but blah blah blah. It did seem a little bit over the top, too serious, but I don't mind. I didn't mind it. You know. The thing about something like Borderlands is it doesn't take it so seriously, so you can have a laugh with it. So it can never be sort of... It's already taking the piss out of itself, so you don't have to do it. Well, something like Division's... Not really the Division, but any game that tries to be serious, sometimes, you know... You have to be the one that has to kind of, like, you know... Not take it as seriously as what it takes itself. Do I make any sense? Right, where am I going? This way. What was the gold one? Now I've got to try not to pull them down or not. The only way. Let's go this way. I have actually got The Walking Dead, and I own it on the 360. I don't know if I've got it on the PS4 or not. I think it was season 2 that they gave away for free, wasn't it, on PlayStation Plus? But I really liked Life is Strange. I loved the hell out of that, and I also liked Tales from the Borderlands. Which I've got, and I keep thinking sometimes, what should I play? I've got the season pass for that, and I've completed the first four episodes, and I just need to finish the last one, and I need to remember to play it. Yeah, Life is Strange, I love that. I thought that was fantastic. I mean, I really liked the previous game that the people who made called Remember Me. I thought that was... Some people didn't like it, but I really liked it. I just really liked the style. So I actually just bought the... Because I like Remember Me, I just bought the season pass, like, unseen for Life is Strange. And I was so happy when it turned out to be, like, one of the best games to come out last year. I went for to let Chloe die end for Life is Strange. It seemed to feel like the right one for me. It seemed like the entire game was you know, trying to tell you that Chloe had to go, and I think that was the better ending, because I think that was the only, that was the, that seemed to feel to me that that was what the story was. Okay, well, it's going to be interesting. I mean, I don't know what they're going to do, if they're going to, you know, make a season two or whatever. Well, I liked Chloe, I kind of felt that I had various points in that game. I think the game was trying to teach us something interesting about life. That life is I just felt that the game was trying to teach me a lesson about life, and the lesson is that life, death is a part of life for all of us. All the people that we'll know will be gone, and we'll be gone, and all the people that we love will be gone one day. Death is a part of life, and I think that the game was telling me that Chloe had to get, it was Chloe's time to go. No matter how much, you know, Max wanted to save Chloe, it was, even though she had time traveling powers, it wasn't, what her time traveling powers gave her was the ability to spend another week with her friend, rather than her friend die in the bathroom being shot by what's the guy's name? Nathan. It was that, with that, Chloe was meant to die, but Max was given the ability to spend another week with her best friend, because she hadn't seen her for 5 years. And that, think of yourself, or think of people that you know, or people that you don't know, what they would give anything to spend another week with their loved ones. And that was the magic of Life is Strange, and that was the special power that Max was given, was to spend another week with her friend. There we go. That's what I think. Right, what am I doing here? Well, thank you very much. I think your opinions are great as well, dude. It feels like a bit of a one-way conversation that we tend to have most of the time. No, we did have a chat, didn't we, when we played Destiny. But, it's great. I just speak my mind, and I think I've just been around in this world long enough just to see it a little bit more clearly. Well, when I spoke to you, your English was fine, absolutely fantastic, so I wouldn't worry about it too much. You are more than eloquent enough, my friend. Well, of course you're lazy, there's too many great video games to play. What can I say? Let's buy the map. Okay. Let's see where, let's see how big the level is. Oh, look at all that. Oh, there's a silver one. Silver apple. I mean, as much as I love video games, I like to think what, how much more I could have done with my life if I didn't spend all this time playing them. But there you go. That's the life I wanted. I can't imagine living a life without all these wonderful games in it. There you go. I think I'm going to go down there and get that bag. I think I might have to call it a day soon. What time is it? Yeah, it's getting late. I'll do a little bit more. Oh, level 38, what level are I? Level 39, okay. This could be fun. You're just an hour ahead of me. That's about half past 11 here. And there's work tomorrow to do. I think video games have made me a better person. I mean, my girlfriend, who I've got a kid with, my son. My girlfriend, I met through playing video games. Exactly. So many great friends I met through playing video games. My girlfriend through some friends that I used to know on a video games forum, and we used to have meetups, and we used to play World of Warcraft together, and you know, so video games are a wonderful thing, and you know, and I don't think there's much of a stigma attached to it anymore. Certainly not. Maybe there was in the past, but so many people play games now that, you know, it's a valid pastime. Isn't anyone who criticises video games for being a waste of time is just someone who doesn't understand. And so everyone plays video games, everyone likes video games, whether it's, you know, someone's mum playing Candy Crush Saga on their smartphone. They don't even consider themselves video gamers, but they probably spend 10 hours a week playing video games on their smartphones. They're gamers. They're gamers like the rest of us. The whole world are video gamers. My son, my nearly 4-year-old son, he's a video gamer. You should see him play Mario. We completed Super Mario 3D World the other day, me and him, together. Me and my 3-year-old son completed Mario. Awesome. しれない Yummy. Okay, look at this, this is a yummy one. ありがとう。
400 I could be. Okay, dude, yeah, I was going to be playing for much longer myself. I'm just going to finish up this bit here, so... No, it's always good to have a chat with you, mate. You take it easy and have a good day tomorrow. And I'll see you again soon, and if I don't see you beforehand, let's hope, definitely, perhaps we'll get some fun together in the Dark Zone in the Division. See you later, mate. Take it easy.
ありがとうございました。